बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। एक्टिवेशन एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ फैटी एसिड्स इन द माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया एंड फैटी एसिड ऑक्सीडेशन। एज वी ऑलरेडी नो, फैटी एसिड सिंथेसाइज इन साइटोसोल एंड ऑक्सीडाइज इन माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इन माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल मैट्रिक्स। आफ्टर डी नोवो सिंथेसिस ऑफ फैटी एसिड्स इन साइटोसोल, फैटी एसिड्स शुड बी इन एक्टिव फॉर्म, should be activated before it translocate from cytosol to mitochondria. Free fatty acids that enters the cytosol from the blood cannot pass directly through mitochondrial membrane but must undergo a series of three reactions. First, the catalyzed by a family of isoenzymes which found at inner and outer mitochondrial membrane called fatty acyl CoA synthetase. Look at this figure. The inactive form of fatty acid should be in which the carboxylic group going to be added with coenzyme A by the enzyme acyl CoA, fatty acyl CoA synthetase. Enzymes available at inner and outer mitochondrial membrane allow to attach the coenzyme A at carbonyl carbon and by the expenditure of ATP into AMP and pyrophosphate. Now let's see the mechanism of action, that how this taking place, the role of fatty acyl CoA, the role of fatty acyl CoA synthetase allowed to utilize the molecule of ATP. The two terminal phosphate groups from ATP cleaves, and the next carboxylic group of fatty acid is going to be attached with the adenosine monophosphate after release of two terminal phosphates by the enzyme fatty acyl CoA synthetase, and the product is fatty acyl adenylate. Now in this fatty acyl adenylate, the thiol linkage of coenzyme A, they attach with the active carbon of carbonyl carbon of fatty acid and leave cleavage the bond between this carbon and oxygen of adenosine monophosphate to release adenosine monophosphate and have fatty acyl CoA, the activation of fatty acid by the same enzyme fatty acyl CoA synthetase. The two reaction process are repeated again. In first step, the molecule of ATP, two terminal phosphate released, this carbonyl group, they're going to be attached with the AMP adenosine monophosphate to yield fatty acyl adenylate. In this fatty acyl adenylate, cleavage of this adenosine monophosphate occurs and the thiol linkage between coenzyme A and active carbon of this carbonyl group of fatty acid takes place to yield fatty acyl CoA by the same enzyme fatty acyl CoA synthetase. On the other hand, pyrophosphate utilize this enzyme inorganic pyrophosphatase to convert it, pyrophosphate into two inorganic phosphates. Now once the fatty acyl CoA synthesized and fatty acids become activated, now it's ready to translocate from cytosol to mitochondria by the help of carnitine shuttle system. Oxidation, fatty acid oxidation shuttle system for further fatty acid oxidation. Oxidation take place in mitochondria because the mitochondrial matrix contains the enzymes for fatty acid oxidation. Once the fatty acid becomes activated, it's ready to translocate from cytosol to mitochondria. Translocation fatty acids entry into mitochondria by carnitine transports. We should know about the carnitine, its chemistry and function. Look at the structure of carnitine. Have the hydroxyl group at beta carbon, have the 3-methyl group and nitrogen at gamma carbon. So we called chemically we called beta hydroxy 3-methyl ammonium butyric acid. Chemically the carnitine we called 3-beta hydroxy gamma trimethyl ammonium butyric acid. Distribution. Carnitine widely distributed in yeast, milk, liver, and particularly large quantities found in mussels and in meat extracts. Small amount of carnitine also found in blood, to 7 to 14 milligrams per ml. Functions of carnitine. Carnitine acts as a carrier molecule. Number one, it facilitates a long chain of fatty acyl CoA for oxidation in mitochondria. And number two, it also facilitates exit of acetyl CoA and acetoacetyl CoA from mitochondria to cytosol, where the fatty acid synthesis takes place. Oxidation. Now the oxidation of before the oxidation of fatty acid, we should note that how to look at this figure that shows that how the carnitine they translocate from cytosol to mitochondria, how the carnitine act as a carnitine shuttle to translocate the activated form of fatty acids from cytosol to mitochondria. Cytosolic side, mitochondrial side. In cytosolic side, look at this activated form of fatty acid in cytosol. First it cleaves coenzyme A. Coenzyme is still accommodate in cytosol. So the fatty acyl group, now it's make a complex with carnitine molecule to make a fatty acyl carnitine. This release of coenzyme A and make a complex between fatty acyl group with carnitine. Reaction catalyzed by the enzyme which located at the outer mitochondrial membrane called carnitine acyl transferase 1. Carnitine acyl transferase 1 allowed to release coenzyme A from fatty acyl CoA and it keeps in cytosol and attach carnitine with fatty acyl to make a fatty acyl carnitine complex. This fatty acyl carnitine is ready to translocate from cytosol to mitochondria and direction catalyzed by carnitine acyl transferase 1 located at the outer mitochondrial membrane. Once the fatty acyl carnitine translocate inside the mitochondrial matrix, another enzyme located at the inner mitochondrial membrane called carnitine acyl transferase 2 catalyzed to release the carnitine group from fatty acyl group and carnitine return back from mitochondria to cytosol to accommodate another new fatty acyl group. Now this fatty acyl after release of carnitine, now it's ready to accommodate with the mitochondrial coenzyme A. So this is the mitochondrial coenzyme A already exists in mitochondria. Once the fatty acyl they release from fatty acyl group released from dissociate carnitine, this coenzyme A attached with the fatty acyl group to make a fatty acyl CoA. Now it's called a mitochondrial fatty acyl CoA. Reaction catalyzed by carnitine acyl transferase 2. This fatty acyl CoA, mitochondrial fatty acyl CoA, now it's ready to oxidize by the help of beta oxidation. Oxidation of fatty acids. Fatty acids exhibit a very high rapid turnover rate with a half-life of only 1 to 3 minutes, and they are rapidly taken up by the tissues and metabolized. stages of oxidation of fatty acids. Mitochondrial oxidation of fatty acid take place in three stages. First stage consists of beta oxidation, where the fatty acids undergoes oxidative removal of successive two carbon units in the form of acetyl-CoA. The total 8 acetyl-CoA molecules yield. Formation of each acetyl-CoA required 4 hydrogen atoms. That includes a 2 pairs of electrons and 4 hydride ions. Formation of each acetyl-CoA requires the removal of 4 hydrogen atoms from the fatty acyl moieties by the help of dehydrogenases. Look at in second stage. In second stage, the acetyl group of acetyl-CoA, they're going to be oxidized to carbon dioxide and citric acid cycle, which also take place in mitochondrial matrix. The first two stages of fatty acid oxidation produce the reducing equivalents in the form of NADH and FADH2. In third stage, the electrons donates to mitochondrial respiratory chain from NADH and FADH2, through which the electron pass to molecular oxygen by the help of hydride ions. They further molecular oxygen going to be reduced into water and the energy going to be yield in the form of ATP. Energy released by fatty acid oxidation thus conserves as ATP. Now, beta oxidation. Location, mitochondrial matrix. Beta oxidation occurs in mitochondrial matrix, and reactions, there are 4 types of reactions, sequence of reaction. First oxidation, then hydration, then second oxidation, and thiolytic cleavage. We may say the first dehydrogenation, hydration, second dehydrogenation, and thiolytic cleavage. So at the end of the beta oxidation, we have acetyl-CoA and fatty acyl-CoA. So these are the end products of beta oxidation. This slide shows the reactions of beta oxidation. Sequence of 4 reactions is seen. First oxidation, then hydration, then second oxidation, and thiolytic cleavage. Look at this figure, shows the structure of palmitic acid. 16 carbon saturated palmitic acid in which the coenzyme A, the carbon which is adjacent to this coenzyme A and carbonyl group called alpha carbon, and the carbon which is adjacent to this alpha carbon be called a beta carbon. So in both of these carbons, reaction going to be occurred. In first step, we called a fatty acyl CoA, the activated form of fatty acid which formed in mitochondria after the translocation of fatty acyl carnitine from cytosol to mitochondrial carnitine. We know that the carnitine returned back in cytosol, and fatty acyl group accommodate another mitochondrial coenzyme to make a fatty acyl CoA. Look at in first step, FADH, FAD, flavin, adenine, dinucleotide, taken up 2 hydrogens, one from alpha, another from beta, to make a alpha-beta unsaturation, and it produce FADH2. And the product is enol-CoA, fatty enol-CoA, delta-2-trans-enol-CoA is formed. The reaction catalyzed by acyl-CoA dehydrogenase, fatty acyl-CoA dehydrogenase. So in next step, addition of hydration take place and addition of water molecule. Hydroxyl group of water added at beta carbon, and the hydrogen of water also added at beta carbon to make a beta hydroxyacyl CoA. Reaction catalyzed by enol-CoA hydrase. In next step, after addition of water, a second oxidation take place, NADH Now it's take two hydrogens. One hydrogen, it's removed from hydroxyl group at beta position. Another hydrogen, it removed from hydrogen of beta carbon. Beta one hydrogen removed from hydroxyl group of hydroxyl group which attach on the beta carbon. Another hydrogen should be removed from the same beta carbon. Reaction catalyzed by hydroxyacyl CoA dehydratase. Hydroxyacyl CoA dehydratase and the NADH, after taking two hydrogens, it produce NADH plus H. Now the ketonic group is established after release of two hydrogen from beta carbons, and the resultant compound is beta keto acyl. So the beta carbon also have a ketonic group now, so we called beta keto acyl CoA. In this beta keto acyl CoA, it is a thiolytic cleavage between this methylene group and ketonic group. So the here the after two carbons, so the thiolytic cleavage occurs. So the reaction catalyzed by thiolase enzyme, incorporation of coenzyme A, and the release of two carbon compounds in the form of acetyl CoA, and we have left 14 carbon fatty acids called fatty acyl CoA. So this repetition of reactions, and this sequence of repetition of reaction should be repeated in first oxidation, then hydration, then second oxidation, then thiolytic cleavage. Repeat that sequence of repetition, repeated again and again until after six cycles we have yield total 8 acetyl CoA after release, after the expenditure of one molecule of palmitic acid. Complete oxidation of one molecule of palmitic acid. We have total 8 acetyl CoA produced at the end of beta oxidation. Dehydrogenation, hydration, second dehydrogenation, and thiolytic cleavage. Now look at this figure. Energy yield from fatty acid oxidation. Oxidation of molecule of palmitic acid to carbon dioxide and water yield the following number of ATPs. Here we are going to discuss it, how many ATPs yield after complete oxidation of one palmitic acid. We know that total 7 NADH plus H produced after complete oxidation of palmitic acid. Total we also know that total 7 FADH 2 produced after complete oxidation of palmitic acid, and we have total 4 acetyl CoA produced because the last two carbons did not require the beta, the reactions of sequence of beta oxidation. So we know that the 7 NADH, each NADH provide 3 ATPs when oxidized by electron transport chains. The total 7 NADH plus H produced. So the net ATP yield from NADH plus H is 21. So we know that each FADH2 provide 2 ATPs when oxidized by electron transport chain. So the total 7 NADH2 produced 14 ATPs from the 8 acetyl CoA. We know that each acetyl CoA produce 12 ATPs when converted to carbon dioxide and water by TCA cycle, by tricarboxylic acid cycle. So the total 8 acetyl CoA produce 96 ATPs. So the total energy yield from one molecule of palmitic acid, that is 131. Out of 131, 2 ATPs already used during the activation of, keep in mind, out of 131 ATPs, 2 ATPs used during the activation of fatty acids, the net ATP production is 129. Now the medium chain fatty acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency. This medium chain MCAD medium chain fatty acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency. It's inheritance 1 in 10,000 births found approximately in 1 in 10,000 births causes. It's inherited disorders causes a decreased fatty acid oxidation. Here, the decreased level of in AMCAD deficiency should be manifested by a decreased concentration of acetyl-CoA, which lowers the pyruvate carboxylase activity. We know that when once the pyruvate carboxylase at low level of acetyl-CoA, once the pyruvate carboxylase activity becomes lower, it means that no gluconeogenesis occurs. This also limits the ketogenesis. It means no ketone bond is also found in those patients, which leads to AMCAD deficiency. So that the clinical manifestation includes a profound fasting hypoglycemia, low or totally absence of ketones in blood, body becomes lethargic, coma, death, and if patient remains untreated. Carbon number 8 to carbon number 10 fatty acyl carnitine is found in blood of these patients. The episodes may provoke by the overnight fast in infants. So the infants may leads to a hypoglycemia, sleepiness, vomiting, overnights, and if remains untreated, it leads to a death. In older child, death also provoked by illness, flu, malaise, just slightly fever causes a loss of appetite and vomiting. Precautions, frequently feeding, especially the high carbohydrate diet and low fat diet, incurs different interval pe har 2-3 ghante baad feed dete rehna chahiye, especially high carbohydrate diet. If these patients not tolerate carbohydrates or glucose orally, so the primary treatment for AMCAD deficiency is the intravenous glucose is given just to overcome the fasting hypoglycemia. 10% cases should be in the form of SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome, cases associated with a SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome, if these patients are not treated timely. Assignments: what is the role of coenzyme A in mitochondrial matrix? B, how carnitine shuttle helps in transport of fatty acids into mitochondria in beta oxidation? And C, what is the primary treatment for MCAD deficiency? So that's all about the activation and transport of fatty acids and fatty acid oxidation via beta oxidation.